Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'm going to create 10 cards using the February card kit by Simon Says Stamp. Now this card kit is already sold out, but I am going to link you down below to all the supplies that are included separately. Now for a chance to win this card kit, make sure to visit my blog and enter your details. You will find a link down below in the description area. So let's take a quick look on what's inside the kit. You get this set of epoxy stickers, nice and puffy. You get this set of elements with little epoxy stickers, sequins, and paper clips. A piece of corrugated cardstock, which is great for adding texture on your cards. You also get 6x6 pattern papers. These are double-sided and you can see the beautiful colors. And they also have nice designs that you can just cut out and stick on top of a card base to end up with an instant card, so it's a very easy card kit to work with. You also get this metal die that cuts out a coffee cup. And as always, you get a clear stamp set, which is all about coffee and tea. You also get 4 different cardstock, and these are the colors. And just because for my monthly series, I am always making 10 cards out of this card kit, I am going to add one more cardstock from my stash. So I'm going to bring in one more white. After cutting and scoring, here are all the card bases ready to decorate. So let's start with card number 1. For the first card, I'm going with the obvious. I'm going to cut out a rectangle out of this pattern paper, leaving out the sentiment. So this way I can fit the image nicely on top of a card base. There is also a pattern paper in the set that comes with ready-made sentiments that you can use on your cards, or you can choose to stamp some of the sentiments from the stamp set. So I'm going to cut out one that says hello, which I am planning to stick at the very top. I'm going to cut a part out of it and create a fish tail in one side just to make it look more interesting. And now this is a ready-made panel. You can just stick it on top of a card base and your card is ready. But if you want, you can take it a step further. I'm going to show you how I'm going to create a shaker card out of it. So I'm taking my craft knife and I'm going to cut out parts of this image. Make sure that when you are using your craft knife, you are going very slow. It's easier if you don't put a lot of pressure and go over and over the lines one or more times. And you can see how I combine my craft knife with my scissors to make sure that I cut out everything, leaving a nice hole. I'm going to do the same thing for the next one. And now from what's left, I'm going to make sure that I remove all that blue space all around the donuts and my macaroons. And now that I have all my elements ready, I'm going to work directly on my card base. I have chosen a white card base. I'm going to make sure that I secure this panel on top of my card base just temporarily. And I'm going to insert back in the image the macaroons and the donuts. And now it's all a matter of creating a shaker card. So I'm going to apply some tape at the back of those little windows. I'm going to stick an acetate at the back. And then, as I always do, I'm going to use my foam tape, go all around those windows. And inside those windows, I'm going to add some diamond dust. This is a product I had for years. It looks like sugar. It's chunky and shiny, and it gives a great sparkle on your cards. And now I'm going to stick this panel on top of my card base, making sure that I align everything correctly so that you can see the switch through the windows. My card is pretty much finished. All that's left to do is to stick the sentiment. I'm going to add a piece of foam tape at the back as well. And I'm going to finish off my card by adding some touches of shine with my clear Wing of Stella glitter pen. For this card, I'm working on this 6x6 pattern paper from the kit. It has a very subtle design on top that probably you cannot see at the moment. You will see a close-up photo later on. So I'm going to stamp twice this coffee cup. And I'm also going to stamp on a piece of white cardstock because I need only the cups to be white. I'm going to stamp them twice. And now I'm going to go ahead and do some coloring. I did stamp everything with my Memento Tuxedo Black ink because I am going to use alcohol markers to color everything. And today I'm going to use my Spectrum Noir markers. I want the cups to be white, so I'm just adding a little bit of shading there, just to make them look more three-dimensional. And once they are ready, I'm going to use my scissors to cut them out. So I'm going to do a lot of paper piecing for this card. And I'm going to stamp this coffee cup on top of this corrugated cardstock, just because I want to cut out the sleeve for the cups. I don't know if that's how that thing is called. Anyway, I'm going to call it a sleeve, and you can just comment down below and let me know if there is a proper name for that. I don't need a perfect impression for that. I just want to follow the lines with my scissors, so I can cut it out, and then I'm going to paper piece it on top of my coffee cup. Now all the parts are ready to go. I'm using my tape and assembling my coffee cups, and the cup is actually pattern paper, although they look pretty much the same with their plastic white tops. You will see the photo at the end. So I'm going to stick those on top again with my tape adhesive. For my sentiment, I'm going with the one that says coffee and friends make the perfect blend, but I want to stamp the first one with and emboss it with Vesamark and emboss it with white embossing powder, and the rest of the sentiment I want it to be black. So I am using my scissors to separate those two lines, but of course if you don't want to cut out your stamps, you can always use masking. So I'm going to stamp the black first, and then I'm going to nest the other on top, remove the line below, and then use my Versamark ink to stamp directly on top of the black line, and then apply my white embossing powder. So I'm going to use my tape adhesive at the back of this pattern paper. I'm going to stick it directly on top of my card base. Again, I'm working on the white card base. And now I am going to apply some tape adhesive at the back of one of those coffee cups, and on the other I'm going to apply some foam tape. This is going to give it a raised effect, so as if one is in front of the other. I achieve that dimensional look that I always want for my cards. I'm also going to add some of these star sequins, and for that I'm using some matte medium by Ranger. This is what I have in that bottle. And that's my second card. For this card, I'm going to work directly on my craft card base, and I'm going to stamp the tea bag. I'm going to create a nice background by stamping the tea bag many times at the background. To do so, I'm using a color by my favorite things, which is called Safety Orange. And once I fill everything at the background, then I am going to use my Prismacolor pencils to color the tea bags. For coloring, I'm going to use only two pencils, the brown and the white one. So I'm going to apply some brown wherever I need to, and then I'm going to cover everything up with the white, which is going to blend out the brown and make it look more faded out. And it's also going to add a nice detail on the tea bag. I am going for a very sketchy look, so I'm not trying to blend out everything perfectly. You can see how sketchy all the lines are. And now this is where I'm going back with my white to blend the brown, and then I'm going to color the tea bag white as well. After coloring my background, I'm going to stamp the sentiment. For that, I'm going to use the same ink pad that I used for the background, and I'm going with a beautiful sentiment that says a woman is like a tea bag. You never know how strong it is until it's in hot water. And I think that the whole design of this card, as well as the sentiment, is make a great card to send to a woman that is having a difficult time in her life. I used my paper trimmer to cut out this sentiment and create a tiny little label. And for the center of my card, I'm going to actually use a real tea bag from my kitchen. And to embellish my label a little bit more, I'm going to use this pattern paper. This is a leftover from my previous card. I'm going to stick this sentiment, so that you can see that yellow line. This is going to give some more interest on my sentiment, and I am going to create a tag out of it. So I'm just chopping out the corners, and then I'm going to stick that on top of the real label. And for one added element and a texture, I'm going to use my tiny attacher and add a staple at the top of this label. So this holds everything nicely together. Now to stick the bag on top of my card base, I'm going to use these glue dots. These are big glue dots, and they are going to hold this bag nicely on top of my card base. At the back, I'm using some foam tape so that I add a little bit of dimension on my sentiment. And now to finish it off, I'm going to stick some of those star sequins just to make my tea bag look more interesting. Again, I'm using my matte medium to stick everything down. And this finishes off the third card for today. And now for a very fun, quick and easy, and a very colorful card. I'm using this pattern paper, and I'm going to cut out a rectangle. This is a stitched die by Simon Says Stamp. And once I have this panel, I'm going to cut out little windows. So for that, I'm going to use this trio of square windows that I have. But to create those windows, if you don't have this die, you can always use your ruler and your craft knife or any other type of punch, square punch that you have, or even your paper trimmer. So I'm going to work on my white card base. For this card, I'm going to temporarily secure this panel on top. With my pencil, I'm going to mark one of those windows where I'm going to stamp the sentiment later on, and on all of the rest of the windows, I'm going to stick the stickers. Now, remember that these stickers have a very strong adhesive and they are not forgiving at all, so as I am sticking them down, I decided that I didn't want those coffee cups to be just close by, but I couldn't remove anything, so I'm just going to go with how it looks at the moment. Now I'm going to remove the panel, and since I have that pencil mark there, I know exactly where my sentiment should fall. So I'm going to place the sentiment directly on top. I'm using my Misty for that. At the back of my panel, I have added some foam tape. Make sure to erase all the pencil lines all around that sentiment. And then I'm going to stick that directly on top, making sure that I align everything correctly. And this is going to finish off the card. Now for this card, I'm going with this beautiful pattern paper, and I'm going to use this die by Simon Says Stamp that consists of two parts. But really, you can achieve the same exact look for this card even if you don't have this die, but just punching out a circle. You will see what I mean later on. So anyway, I'm using my T-ruler just to make sure that I align this die straight, run it through my Sizzix machine, and this is what I end up with. And you can use any of those shapes, but I decided to go with this one. And you can pretty much tell from the shape of it that you can just cut out a rectangle panel from this pattern paper and punch out a circle. Or if you have a die, you can die cut a hole there. And this is why I said at the beginning that you really don't need this die. So anyway, for my sentiment, I'm going to use this green strip of paper from this pattern paper that says "You are my cup of tea," and it says that again and again all over the strip, and I'm planning to stick that on one side of the panel. Notice how I cut out the strip a little bit bigger so that I can attach one on top of the other with my tape adhesive, and now I'm making sure that only the green strip is showing, and then with my scissors I'm going to cut out the inside so that I have that hole again. And now to assemble my card, I'm going to add some tape adhesive at the back of my panel. I'm going to stick that directly on top of my card base, making sure that it is aligned on one side. And then I'm going to use my scissors to cut out the excess paper. In the dicer that I'm using, there is a circle that fits inside that circle that I have already cut out. But again, if you don't have this die, you can just cut out any circle and stick it on top. So I have cut out one out of white cardstock. I'm adding some foam squares at the back to add some dimension. I'm going to stick that just inside the hole that I have already on my paper. And now I'm going to stick on top those two adorable coffee cups, or maybe they are teacups. So anyway, I'm going to stick them side by side. And on top, I'm going to stick one of those glitter hearts from the other set. And I end up with this very simple but adorable card. Now for this card, I'm going to use the coffee cup and I'm going to stamp it on a white panel again and again many times. For that, I'm using my favorite things, black ink, which is very alcohol friendly. So it's not going to smudge or smear when I'm using my Spectrum Noir colors to color everything. I'm going to cover up the whole background with those coffee cups. And now I'm going to use my Spectrum Noir markers to color it. First, I'm going to use my brown marker to color the coffee inside the cups, but again, I'm not paying a lot of attention on how I'm coloring everything here because I will end up covering up the coffee with embossing powder, which is going to give it a nice shine. These are the three colors that I am using for coloring my coffee cups. I'm going to make the whole design monochromatic, so all the cups are going to be exactly the same, but I know that it's going to look beautiful if you go with a rainbow color scheme. The markers I'm using today come from the latest release by Spectrum Noir, so they came up with two sets of 24 new colors for Spectrum Noir, and I'm going to link everything down below. Now, this is an embossing pen, and I'm going to neatly apply embossing ink only where the coffee is, so that I can apply my clear embossing powder, and this is by Nuvo. And this is going to turn my coffee into shiny coffee, which is going to give a nice texture and shine on my background. So I'm going to repeat the same process for all the coffee cups, and now I'm going to use my heat gun and melt the powder. Now for the sentiment, I have used this banner die and cut out a piece of white cardstock, but again, if you don't have the banner, you can easily create that fishtail with your scissors. I am going to use my Misty to stamp the sentiment, and for the sentiment, I'm going with the one that says, with enough coffee, anything is possible. I'm going to stamp that with black ink, and then I'm going to stick that directly on my panel with some foam tape at the back. And to embellish my background a little bit more, in the epoxy sticker set, there are some coffee grains, which I am going to use all over the white space on my background. I'm going to use the craft cardstock as my card base. I'm going to stick the panel on top. And you can see that my panel is slightly smaller than the standard card, so I end up with having that beautiful frame all around. And now you can leave the card as it is, but if you are like me and you cannot stop with little details, I think that no coffee cup is cute enough without polka dots, so I'm going to add some white polka dots here and there on my coffee cups, and for that I'm using my Nuvo drops. And this is going to finish off the card. For this card, I'm working directly on my card base, and I'm going to white emboss the sentiment. I'm going with a sentiment that says, coffee and friends make the perfect blend. I did use that sentiment earlier on one of my cards, making sure that I have stamped everything nicely. And now I'm going to apply some white embossing powder and heat set it. And now I'm using the die that comes in the set to cut out three of those coffee cups in white and three coffee cups in three different colors. And the idea here is to do some paper piecing later on, so I have the top of the coffee cup in white, the main body of the coffee cup in three different colors. I also have the hands in white and the hearts in red. So I'm going to do some assembling now. Notice how I am going to cover up the bag with foam tape, which is going to make all those little holes on the front sticky, so that it's going to be super easy for me to stick everything inside. I'm going to stick those three guys on top of my card base. And now from the white cutouts, I'm going to cut out only the top part and stick it directly on top of my coffee cups. To do so, I'm using my Nuvo glue pen. It's really handy for these tiny little pieces. And now all I need to do is to stick inside those holes the rest of the tiny pieces. So I need to stick inside those tiny little hands, which are this is a very easy card to create, but the tiny little pieces make it really hard. So a great saver is the pick-me-up tool, which really makes this process easier than it looks. I am going to leave a link down below on this tool, and it's really handy to have in your craft room for all those tiny little pieces that you need to pick up. Now I'm also going to color the hearts white with a red marker, and now with my pick-me-up tool again, I'm going to stick them just inside as if they are holding the little heart. I did the same thing for the mouth, but instead of fighting with those tiny little pieces for the eyes, I decided to use my black Nuvo drops and just create my own eyes, which are after all dimensional and they give more of a character to my guys. Now I'm using my clear Wink of Stella glitter pen to add some shine on the hearts, and my card is ready. For this card, I'm going to work with a white card base. I have cut out this panel and stick it directly at the center of my card base. And now from this beautiful pattern paper with all those images, I'm going to cut out the one that says Be Mine with all those little hearts. And this is going to be a great Valentine's Day card. Now I want to create a pocket for this little image, and this is my way of creating a pocket without measuring anything. So I'm just eyeballing it there. I'm using a scrap piece of pattern paper that I have left over from a previous card, and I'm just going to create some flaps on the three sides of this paper so that my image slides nicely inside. I'm eyeballing again how high I need this to be. I'm going to use my trimmer to cut it out. And now you can see how nicely this slides inside. Now I'm using my punch to punch out a little hole at the top so that the recipient knows that there is something inside of that pocket. And it's going to make it easier for him to pull out that little image from the inside. I'm adding some strong adhesive at the flaps of this pocket, and now I'm going to stick that directly on top of my card base. And you can see how my image slides inside. Now, to make it even easier for the recipient to take out this image, I'm going to add a piece of ribbon. And you all know where I found my ribbon. It's in that drawer of shame. So anyway, I am also going to punch out a circle. I am measuring how much I need to fold it to cut it out. And now I'm going to stick that on top of my ribbon. And this is going to cover up the stapler that I have used to hold my ribbon in place. So I'm going to use a glue dot there. And I have a nice top for my tag. And it's really easy to pull out. Now, to decorate the top of that pocket, I have cut out the word U from an older die that I have by Simon Says Stamp. And again, I am going to stamp a Valentine's sentiment that says, P.S. I love you. But instead of stamping the word U, I have it out of a die cut. And I am cheating here because I'm not using the stamp set from the kit. I'm using some Nuvo glue pen at the back of my die cut so that I can stick it easily on top of my little pocket there. And to embellish it even more, I'm going to add some of those stars. I think they go perfectly with the color of the pocket. Again, I'm using my multi-medium that I have in that fine tip bottle. And with my pickup tool, I'm going to stick them directly on top of that glue. And that finishes the card. Now for this card I want to do some masking, so first I'm going to stamp my image. Then I'm going to stamp the same image on a post-it tape, cut it out with my scissors, so that I can use it as a mask. And just because I need only one side, I am not going to bother with cutting the whole image out. I'm going to place it directly on top of my coffee cup and then stamp the other one. So when I peel off the masking, it's going to look as if it's at the bag. I am using my Spectrum Noir markers to color my images, and I am picking the colors based on the colors from the pattern papers. So I'm going to color everything. And now I'm going to use my craft knife and cut out where the coffee should be. I'm going to create a tiny little shaker element here as my embellishment for my card. I'm making sure that I get rid of that white edge with my black marker. And now I'm going to use my scissors and cut out these images. And since this is going to be a shaker element, I have applied some tape adhesive at the back. I am sticking my acetate to cover up the window. And now with my foam tape, I'm going all around that window to create a little pocket where I'm going to apply some micro beads with my spoon just inside the window. I am covering the back with a piece of paper. And I'm going to use my scissors to cut out all the excess, whatever of that paper sticks out. So now I have my embellishment ready. Now I'm going to stamp the sentiment. And for that I'm going with the one that says I only need two things, you and coffee. And I'm actually working on one of the tags that comes out of one of the pattern papers, which is full of those tiny little tags. Now I am going to stamp the rest of the sentiment. And once that's ready, I'm going to apply some tape adhesive at the back and stick my handmade embellishment on top. And as I'm moving to the end, I'm using more and more of my scraps. So I have cut out this little panel out of one of the scraps that I have left from a previous card. On the tag, I am applying one of my eyelets using my crop tile. I'm going to thread some white twine. And my tag is ready. I'm going to stick this little piece of paper on top of my card base and then my tag on top of that. And my card is ready. For my last card, I'm going to use this set by My Favorite Things, and it's going to cut out three little circles, and the panel is going to have a nice scalloped edge. But you can go and create the same design by just cutting out a triangle and use a circle die to cut out three circles at the center. So I'm going to cut out some foam tape. I'm going to go all around those holes just to make sure that I have a nice and sturdy panel. I'm placing it against the card base that I have left over, which is the blue one. I'm going to stamp the sentiment on one corner. And the truth is that this sentiment would look beautiful if it was white embossed, but after creating 9 cards, I was in a hurry. So anyway, I'm going to use the leftover stickers from the epoxy set and I'm going to stick them inside. And the sentiment of this card says, "Life is like a cup of tea. It's all in how you make it." And actually these image stickers help you create different types of tea, like the tea bags or the sugar, etc. So I have used my white gel pen to create some thread for those tea bags. And I'm going to peel off the backing from my tape adhesive and I'm going to stick that panel directly on top of my card base, making sure that I align everything correctly. And that's the last card for today. So now let's take a quick look on all the 10 cards that I created using the February card kit by Simon Says Stamp. And these are my leftovers. For my stash I have the die, the stamp, and of course all those little elements. I still haven't used any of those paper clips. And I have many more images as well as two 6x6 full pattern papers. And these were the cards for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. You will find a full list of all the supplies that I used today down below the description area as well as on my blog. Don't forget to visit my blog and enter that giveaway. Thank you all for watching!